Welcome to Gurukul.com. In this video, we'll talk about how to create Jira issues in bulk using REST API. Whenever you're working on Jira cloud platform and you wanted to create issues in bulk, probably bulk issue create through REST API is a very good option. Here, we'll show you how you can generate or create issues in bulk using REST API. If you wanted to learn Jira REST API, feel free to watch my complete playlist. As of now, I've created more than 50 videos on Jira REST API. Here, I will show you how we can create issues in bulk using REST API. For that, I'm using Postman, and from here, we need to have this endpoints. How we can generate this endpoint? So this is my domain name. To get this domain name, you have to log in into your Jira instance. Straight away, you can copy till here. After that, we need to use the API versions. Next, I'm going to use here REST, then API, and this is version 2, issues in bulk. This will become a complete endpoint for me. And once I will select post method and hit send, this will create an issues. But as of now, I have just defined in body for creation of one issues. How we can create multiple issues at once, I will show you very quickly. Before starting with this, we need to have authentications. As of now, we are using basic authentications method where username is my email ID and I've created API token. If you don't know how to create the API token, feel free to refer my previous video. I've already covered it, so I'm not repeating this time. That's the reason. Let's continue further with creation of issues in bulk and how we can generate the body. Now, once we'll jump into the state, here you can see I've included few of the contains or schemas to create issues through REST API. So first schema is issue updates, which will help us to create issues in bulk. Then the update, there's nothing available here. If you want to update time frame or dates or maybe how much time it is taking for creation of issues, where you can update it. As of now, I'm not defining here. I'm going with the least probability where I will just include the required fields. Required field, it means project name, type of issues, summary, and descriptions. If we have any other required fields, we have to include it here. Now, fields is our main schema where projects, keys, summary, descriptions, and issue types and name all will come in under one schema itself. So field is the main schema. Under that, project, key, summary, descriptions, issue types, and name is there. For creating one issues, it will be much quicker. Let's consider I wanted to create issue name with bulk issue create one. Now I don't want to change the descriptions again and again. Here issue types I'm giving bug, but if based on your preference, if you want to create epic stories or subtasks or tasks, everything can be done by just changing the name itself. So that's the reason I said as of now I'm using bug, but totally depending on your requirements, which issue types you wanted to generate. For every issue types, the procedure will be same. Just we have to change or replace this bug with the story or epic or any other issue types. Now, once I will hit send, this will create issue for me, just one issue for me. Here you can see just one issue is generated. Now, once I will go back to this and search with this issue name DM48, I will get the exactly same details which I entered here. Now, you can see exactly same issues is created for me. Now, instead of that, I want to create multiple issues at once. So what I will do here, straight away, copy from here till this point, add semicolon and paste it here. Now you can see exactly same schema is available here. Instead of the summary, I will add issue type 2. Let's consider we are struggling with recording in Amazon website. So recording in Amazon is not working. That's one. Again, I wanted to create one more issue here. So straight away, I will hit semicolon and then add here. I'm not changing any other fields because key is my project key ID, that is the unique ID. So here I'm using DM, which you will get it from this. So data migrations is my project name. And once I will navigate it to their project settings, I will get the key. So here is the key, exactly same key ID I'm using for this one. So what I was trying to show you, DM48 issues, which is created here at once, but this time I wanted to create three issues together. That's the reason I'm modifying it summary here. So in this scenario, first one is the same. I wanted to create here. Chat is not working. Now we have three summaries and this one also I wanted to update. So credit balance or gift card balance is not showing. Now it's ready with all three issues and all three issue types I've selected here, bug. But if you wanted to make this as a story straight away, write here story. Once I will click on send, this will create three issue types for me, which is let me show you here, 49, 50 and 51. Last issue types I modified with the story. Let's see how it looks. So let's first check 49, 50, and then we'll see 51, which is the story. So let me refresh this page first and then generate it. So DM 49. Now you can see gift card balance is not showing, exactly same message which we have added or summary which we have added here. So gift card balance is not showing, and then descriptions, same descriptions will be available here. Next, I wanted to see here is next issue is recording in Amazon is not working. So that is DM 50. You can see recording in Amazon is not working. Description is the same and this is a defect. Now I wanted to show you the last one, that is 51, which is user story. So you can see this is the part of user story. Chat is not working is the summary or title, and description is exactly same thing. This is how we can create issues in bulk through Jira REST API. What will be the uses of it? Let's consider we are working on any automations piece and team found some issues. So to report these issues within our agile projects, team is using this REST API. Second example could be, let's consider the team who wanted to report this defect, they don't have the UI access. In that case also, they will create issues directly through REST API. And creating issues in bulk through REST API will be probably a very prominent and efficient way where we have to report or add the defect very quickly through REST API. Simply, we have to just single click on any options and this will create a defect. So that's how we can create issues in bulk through Jira REST API. Hope you enjoyed the content. If you think so, this will be useful. Don't forget to share within your circle. Thank you for watching.